Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Learn with Luke. Today we're going to be talking about Xometry's newest feature, Supplier Team Management. I'm Luke, Xometry's Community and Marketplace Engagement Lead, and I'm joined by a returning guest today, Alex Gunter. Alex was on a previous episode of Learn with Luke where he talked about everything partner portal. If you haven't seen that episode yet, make sure to check it out. I'll be linking it in the comments below. But Alex, let's hop into it. How are you? Do you want to give everybody that maybe didn't see that previous episode a little introduction?
Yes, thank you, Luke. So as a product manager, I work closely with the job board and the entire supplier experience. On the previous episode, we went through some of the tips related to filters and the job board. And today I'm excited to show you for the first time, the ability to invite employees to the portal and give them limited access to the job board or the current work pages or any of the other areas. And for each one of those logins to be able to control their own notification settings. This has been asked for from the very beginning, and we're happy to bring an intuitive new dashboard called Team Management to all of the partner accounts out there to let you start giving your employees that access to the areas of the job board and the current work and supplier portal that you've been needing. So without further ado, let's take a look. I'm going to share my screen.
Man, I'm excited.
And what you see on the left is, let's say Luke is the primary user for the partner account. So he's logged in, doesn't have any job offers on his board, but he's going to go to the menu next to the Xometry logo and scroll down to partner settings where he sees team management and notification settings. So for the first time, there's two new additions to partner settings. And let's start out with team management. This is where Luke will be able to see all of the invitations that he has sent out and all of the users that have accepted those invitations. Let's start out with inviting an additional user to this account. So I'll type in my email with a couple of numbers since this is a demo. learnwithluke@xometry.com. If I press space, you see that I'm able to add multiple emails at once. And right off the bat, each individual email will get an invitation. If they accept that invitation, when they log in, they will have restricted access only to the current work page and to the completed work page, and they won't be able to see prices. That is, unless I come back to the team management dashboard and give them the ability to see job prices, access to job board. I can also control whether they have access to shop finances or not. So let's go ahead and send this one invitation. And you see that we have a green confirmation toast in the top. And on the tab that says invitations, we now can see that this invitation has not been accepted yet, which means I can easily resend the invitation. If a few days later, that person still hasn't seen their email and accepted the invitation, an easy way to resend it. You'll have to wait 15 minutes or more before resending it. We want to make sure that we're not sending too many emails to your team. All right, let's look at what that invitation will look like. So it says, accept or decline. We want that person to decide whether they want to join the partner ID. So we don't automatically add them as a user to your account. And then as soon as they click accept, they will be asked to enter their email, go through the password reset flow where it will ask them for their first name and last name and to set a password. Okay, now, as Alex, I have received a notification from Luke and I have accepted it. So I'm gonna log into the supplier portal. We'll go to sign in. And the first page that I see is the current work page, because the default permissions for any new member that is invited is current work and completed work. If I try to navigate to shop finances, a page that I don't have access to, I see a helpful error message. And this is how all new members start out. All right, so we've covered in sending an invitation and logging in as an invited member. Now let's look at the notification settings. I have a dedicated page that shows me only those notifications for the areas that I've been given permissions. In this case, just current work. There are no notifications for the completed work page, so we're just seeing the one. if we switch computers and go over to Luke's, as an admin of that partner account, Luke will see all of the types of notifications, including job board and the account. These are things like an application for an additional manufacturing process or an inspection capability. These can only be seen on the notification settings page if the member is an admin. And that's it. Every member will be able to see notification settings that depend on the permissions that the admin has given them. They can be upgraded to be able to see job board, able to see shop finances, but only after they have accepted their invitation and the admin has granted those permissions, and we'll do that last. So we go back to team management and we're gonna say, all right, let's edit permissions. And right now we want to add job board access. And if Alex logs out and logs back in, instead of being taken to current work, we will be taken to the job board. And that, in a nutshell, is the supplier team management. We're really excited to bring this functionality to all of our manufacturing partners. We hope that you'll go ahead and send invitations and use the resend button to manage your team so that you're no longer restricted to sharing a login or not giving those employees of yours access to the areas that they need. And that's it, Luke.
Absolutely. That was great, Alex. Thank you so much for joining us today and teaching us. I've learned a lot, and I'm sure the community has as well. As people are testing out this new supplier team management feature, make sure to leave comments in the questions below, guys. I mean, we hear from you guys and we want to make these products as best we can for you guys. And so as you're messing with this and playing around with it, make sure to give us your feedback, give us your comments, questions, concerns, anything like that. And thanks everyone for watching, and join us next week for another episode of Learn with Luke.